Hello everyone and welcome back to another self-indulgent booster pack unboxing for a dead TCG trading card game, if you aren't aware, because I like doing them and I kind of like also just, we're like following the steps towards, I was going to say a murder, but not a murder, it's just a death. The steps towards a death, following on from wave two, the combiner themed wave was the siege themed wave, which I think tied in with the Netflix show. Or maybe just the toy line that was connected to that. I don't know, Hasbro slash Wizards, they want things done in a very particular way. And I also think, just in general, that they overvalue the Transformers license based on how well the live action movies did. But that's another conversation for another day. This is Wave 3, and it also came out in 2019, I think. Yeah, so it must have been the tail end, like they did a double wave in a year. So this would have been at the tail end of 2019 that Siege Wave 1, or Pack 1, came out. They did do a second Siege Wave, and this one seems the hardest to pick up of those eras. Like, finding a Wave 2 and a Wave 1 box is actually still very doable. Finding these is actually kind of difficult for any kind of reasonable price. I don't know why that is. Really, maybe it was considered the best wave. I do know for sure that my favourite side character, Optimus Prime, is available in this wave only, and that's Ultra Magnus, but sadly he's a super rare, so I doubt we're going to be seeing him. But either way, there's 30 packs in here waiting to be opened, so let's get this box cut open, and we're just going to do it all over again. One last quick thing to mention before we actually just start cracking into these. They started doing small characters as the gimmick for this wave, because every wave had to have a gimmick. So you still get the one large character card, but you also get a guaranteed small character card that's a standard playing card size or Pokemon card sized guy. And still get the six battle cards, and I think the odds are basically the same. The odds were on the side. Let me see here. I forgot to check that. Chance of super rare is 1 in 50, so that stayed the same. Chance of uncommon small transformer character card 1 in 5. Each booster pack contains one rare battle card. Okay. Oh, and I spilled them. Let's start with this one then, since it fell out. We'll put this over here as always, and I'm pretty sure that made the focus go nuts, but there we go, the pack's in focus, that's the important part. And let's see, if you want to place a bet on whether or not we get a super rare, feel free. We should get at least three rares, regardless. And let's see what comes in this pack. We get advertisements for toys now, so they were getting desperate by this stage, I guess. And we've got Raider Ion Storm, which is a seeker I'm not familiar with. Oh, and we do have a small card. Oh, cool. Cool picture, though. I enjoy lightning power things in general. He's a common. And then we also got standard playing card size, Private Stakeout, which is an Autobot. Do they have rarities? They do. And he is a common. And it does say there, Wave 3. So there is our first draws. I'll be forming the piles over here as per usual. But I'll do that between takes. Let's have a look at the battle cards and see what our guaranteed rare one is, along with two uncommons and three commons. Open up. That's a new one, I don't recognize that. So Dismantling Claw, Battlefield Report. Oh yeah, that's the other thing, they added secret actions in this wave as well, which is basically trap cards. Smoke Cloak, which is kind of hard to say. Hiding Spot, which is another secret action. And then, oh, did they do it in a different order? Common, common, common. Uncommon. Oh, they did the rare at the end now. There's the rare. That makes more sense, I guess, to go up in rarity. Quartermaster, Wheeljack giving Ironhide a gun. Okay, fair enough. Both sides of cardboard, by the way, are the same advertisement for toys. So, yeah, like I was saying, maybe the writing was on the wall, even by this wave, that it wasn't doing quite as well as you would have hoped. Which, the more I learn about this game, it becomes more and more that I think that's such a shame. We have Sergeant Chromia, who I'm not familiar with, and then the little card below. Yes, we do. Ooh, a gun. So this is another common, though. Another Lady Autobot I am not familiar with, but she goes there in the common pile. And whoever this is, they become a gun when they flip over. Oh, I remember him. I remember this toy. Nightstick. Yeah, okay, so he's one of the Headmaster slash Target Masters. Oh, well, they call them Battle Masters, I guess. I totally recognize this. I didn't have the toy, but I recognize him from the cartoon. Yeah, I do, for sure. That's bringing back some memories right there. And he is, oh, he's an uncommon. Okay, I'll keep him on his robot side though. So I'm doing common, uncommon, rare, etc. for the little guys as well. Toys advertisements go to one side. And then the battle cards. Medic. Brainstorm. That's an old one. Frag Toss. Rock Toss. We have a theme going. EMP Wave. That's Ultra Magnus. I want his card. And Scavenge the Battlefield. That is Starscream using Megatron's Blaster. It's pretty fun. I think in terms of pack design, this is my favourite front cover for them. The Wave 1 ones were fine. The Wave 2, I don't care about Predaking. But these, I think, will be awesome. Like War Era Optimus. This pack is not playing along as nicely. There we go. I think it's a Decepticon. I got a little glimpse there. Was I right? Oh, it's a damaged card. For all the advertisements and bits of cardboard you put in, that's the first damaged card I've seen. But that is, yeah, it's been... Well, hopefully he's not a rare then. Let's see. We have... Run Amok. He's a common, so hopefully we'll get a replacement. I'm putting him to one side, because, yeah, he's got a dog-eared corner. And then we have Raider Roadhugger, who is... I don't recognize this guy. He is a common. And he goes in the common pile, right there. Well, considering how many packs I've been opening over the last few weeks, getting an actual damage card instead of just like a bent one, that's an abnormality, rather, compared to the norm, because usually they're actually very good with their protection. Plus, maybe I bent it as I opened it, I don't know. Defensive formation, personal targeting drone, reactive armor. Oh, that went out of focus there again, didn't it? Compact shield, rock toss again, and our rare is heroic team up. Bring me closer, I want to hit them with my lightsaber. And next we're doing this pack, I'm alternating between sides again. Just because. There we are, it's gonna open fine. Just gotta make sure I don't drop the smaller card. One of the packets gets in the way, there we go. It is a Decepticon, it is Captain Starscream in his Cybertronian jet form. And the little card is... Oh, it's Ravage! This is our first rare as well. Captain Starscream. So yeah, the other thing in this wave is everybody has ranks because it was during the war, like the height of the war on Cybertron. So another version of Starscream, but a very different style. That's how they looked in episode 1. Very neat. How many stars? 12 stars! He always seems to be a lot of stars. So that's a rare, so we haven't had any uncommon big characters yet. And Ravage, of course, the cassette tape that turns into a doggo. He is a common, so I suspect we'll see more than just the one of him. Which is fine, I like Ravage. And then our battle cards are all the cards involving chucking things. So we have Frag Toss here. One moment. There we are. Frag Toss, Dismantle. EM24 IR Laser Launcher. Sounds like something from Battletech. Spinner Rims. That's a fun picture, actually. The Decepticon hubcaps. Rock Toss seems very common. And Microcapacitor is the rare from this pack. Forgot to mention, but looking at that other Rock Toss there reminded me, this wave also added black pips to the potential pips cards can have. So there was no pips, orange pip, blue pip, white pip when the game launched. Wave 2 added green pips. And then this wave added black pips, which all do different things. So we've got Sideswipe. Private Sideswipe, who is our first uncommon. Okay, I asked for one and I got one. I always get Sideswipe and Cliffjumper confused in more recent media because they don't look that different anymore. Because originally Cliffjumper was just a recolor Bumblebee. But they just look a little different now. Depends on the franchise. And then we also have Private Mudslinger. I had this toy. He's a little, yeah, a tiny guy, yes. I had a bunch of these tiny guys. A silver car, this was the monster truck, orange truck I think as well. I had a bunch of these, that's a common. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I still have them somewhere, but none of my toys are from childhood are in any kind of respectable condition. I was a child who played with his toys, not just had them to have them. So we have Diagnosis Autofocus, and it must be manually done by me every time. Diagnosis, Urban Camel, another Dismantle, so there's the Black Pip, which gives you Pierce in terms of the rules of the game. Point Defense System, Anticipation Engine, and then finally we have Unconventional Flying Object with Alpha Trion. Is he waving or is he doing a Naruto Jutsu sign? I think he's probably waving, right? That's a very funny looking card. So we've had mostly common so far, which is different to the previous waves. I don't know if that's just because we got really lucky with the previous waves, or maybe we're just really unlucky with this one, I don't know. I know the one card I definitely want that we're almost certainly not going to get, but oh well, Red Alert. Another person I always confuse with Sideswipe. So Red Alert, well, that's a very fun picture of him. With a like battle axe or battle mace. He's just a common, but that's okay. And then we also have Raider Visper. So it's a common, he goes in that pile. Visper gives stealth or has stealth. I don't recognize him at all. And he is a common. Scrapping green cards is his thing. I didn't realize he was so against immigration. Battle cards. There we are. I've got a little bag for these baggies this time just so cleanup is easier, but it's very quickly needing sorted. Dismantle, Calculate Strike, that's new. Brainstorm, we've seen. Bolster, I don't think we've seen. HV Electron Breacher, that's new. Decepticon Weapon. And then, ooh, Laser Cutlass is the rare. Very neat. That looks like Lady Cup. I'm not sure who that is. Alright, let's see what's next. Am I doomed to only ever get very rare Starscream related cards? It's a Decepticon, I saw the purple. I'd prefer more Autobots. Oh, unless, of course, it's the one that was damaged, in which case, perfect. Because now I've got a non-damaged version. Yeah, no dog-eared corner this time. Perfect. So I'm fine with that being our first duplicate. And then we got RS Firesteel Saber. It's an uncommon, so it turns into a weapon when it dies, presumably, since it's a Battlemaster related thing. Neat, and it was uncommon. So that's our second uncommon, I think? Nightstick was uncommon. Okay, if I want it on the side where it says it's rarity, they have to be on their weapon side for whatever reason. I guess because that's their equivalent of a vehicle form. Although the rarity on the character cards is on their bot form. So that is weird. Never mind. Brainstorm seems pretty common. Basic combat protocol, haven't seen that yet. Repurpose. Wheeljack is on a lot of these cards. Covert Armor. I didn't know RC had cloaking capabilities. Reflex Circuit. Megatron fighting Ironhide. And then our rare is W5 Gyro Blaster. With Sideswipe on the front. That is Sideswipe, right? Yes. See, again, it depends on the visual style. Somewhere deep within, there may yet be a super rare. Which to this date is still highly valued. Is that the same again? No, Run Amok and Run About. Oh, they do work together though, because they mention each other. So he is also a common. Yeah, they look pretty similar too. So they are obviously related Decepticons. There we go, and we have Private Red Heat. Oh yeah, that was another one of the little guys, the little toys. It was a fire engine thing. Yeah, I remember him as well. So he's another common. So these are little ones that have like low-ish star values to fill spaces in teams if you have those awkward number of points and don't want to take a battle card that was worth stars as well, of the 25 you're allowed. And speaking of battle cards, we have ourselves Urban Camo, which is so camouflaged the camera's struggling. There we are. Defensive Formation again, that secret action. Force Field, the Electron Breacher again. Steady Shot, and Callous Leadership. Oh, he is certainly very callous. Yes, that's his whole thing. And even if we don't find the super rare thing I'm looking for, we're still due two more rares at least. And I think that's guaranteed. Unless we get very unlucky. Oh, so we have one of the Fire Cons. Flame Feather. I remember these being real stupid looking in bot form. Yep. Uncommon though. Uncommon, but that does not excuse the chunkiness of these things. How many of them was there? I think there was only three or four. Binary Edgewing Scythe. I wouldn't call that a scythe, but it's uncommon and it looks cool. Looks like Swoop on this side. Swoop crossed with Laserbeak. In terms of a little card, apologies, it's struggling with that, isn't it? Let's try and get it in focus in case you care about the stats. There we go, right there. Hopefully it'll stay in focus when I flip it over, in case that wasn't in focus. There we go. And then, if we put that on uncommon. So a lot of the uncommons are weapons, then. Because that's 3 for 3. And the commons are the box. That actually have a vehicle form, I mean. And our battle cards. We've got a laser launcher, which I think we haven't seen yet. Doesn't ring a bell. And then we've got another force field. Is that focused? It's not, is it? I think it is now. There we go. Force field. Smoke thrower. A lot of weapons, but I guess this is war themed. Metal detector. Anticipation engine. And our rare is pop a wheelie. That's fun. Neat. The piles are a little bit out of whack, so I'm not 100% sure that I'd be evenly taking from both sides. Hopefully I have. This packet is not opening nicely, but it did open. And we have, look at that packet was bent badly. And it has, unfortunately, also bent the card. Did their quality start dropping with this wave? Because they were all in a sealed booster box, so one packet being bent and the rest largely being fine doesn't seem correct. But we do have Captain Wheeljack. He is an uncommon. Hopefully we'll get a copy of him. It's not as badly bent as that run amok was, but still kind of annoying. And we got Private Tote. Another one of those little cards. I can't remember if I had this guy or not. I recognise his bot form more than his car form, because his car form just looks like Ironhide. But again, he seems to be a common, and then the uncommons seem to be weapons, and there doesn't seem to be any rares, at least not so far. Although maybe you'd feel kind of cheated if one of your rares was a little guy and not a big character card. And they like throwing frag grenades. Reactive armor again. Smoke thrower. EMP wave again. Bolster, and our rare is Firecon Flame. Okay, so it's for Firecons only, of which we've only found one so far. I choose you, not Pikachu. That ripped okay, I think I saw all about colours. Look at that, that same corner again. The box was sealed. I'm not sure what's up with that. So we've got Specialist Flame War. So this is a different version of a character we've seen before. This version is uncommon, though. So that goes on top of Wheeljack there. And then we also have another Private Red Heat. The movie starring Arnold S. and... I don't remember who his co-star was. Either way. Oops, as I hit the camera, apologies. This packet isn't open nicely. I'm going to have to turn it upside down. Try again from the other side. There we go. Well, we have ourselves another medic. Pure do damage. Oh, it's just a straight up heal, huh? Neat. And hopefully in focus more or less. So we've got medic, we've got a combat dagger. Calculated strike, we haven't seen a combat dagger yet. Steady shot again. Another rock toss, of course, which is a blue or a black orange pip. Ultra Magnus armor. Great, now I just need the man himself, although this looks neat. Let's try and get it in focus. Is there a rare gun? It's really struggling with it, isn't it? I think that's in... it doesn't look in focus to me. But it is really, really struggling today. There we are. Thank you. Blue-orange, 2 extra attack, 2 extra defense, put on all bots only. Very, very cool looking. I just need the man himself now. I'd also settle for just a rare in general. I feel like we should stumble upon our second one soon. If we... don't immediately on this, of course. I think I saw all about colours. I did. And that same corner again. Although, honestly, look at this. That one's quite damaged in general. Private RC, who is a common. Oh, is she fighting one of those things from the Headmaster Planet whose name I don't remember? Because they had, like, pincers like that. Okay, so that's a common version of RC. Neat. Unfortunately, actually damaged. Like, it isn't just that it's bent on this side, there is a very noticeable crease line. I can't tell if that's just because of this box, or if standards did start slipping with this wave's release. Private Top Shot. First one him, did not remember him at all. And he is a common, and has a bot form. So, yeah, that's still following that trend. Because the box itself is undamaged, it still had the wrap around it, which means they went into the pack before being sealed like that. But it could have just been unlucky, I suppose. Defensive formation, diagnosis, don't think we've seen that before. Smoke cloak again, point defense system, spinning rims, and energy pack is the rare for this one. I'm being more consciously aware of how I'm opening these packs. I'm not ripping it, like I'm not bending it is what I mean. I'm just trying to get the seam, like I definitely wouldn't be doing it to the extent that it would damage the card. Ooh, we got Optimus Prime. The Cybertronian truck version of Optimus Prime, 11 stars. And he is, oh, a rare. Okay, so we got our second rare, General Optimus Prime, very cool looking. I had the toy that looked like this, which is not my favourite look for him, for the record, but I did have the toy that looked like this. It's pretty neat. I don't know how he compares to the other versions. Obviously, there's a lot of versions of him because he's very popular. So, Starscream and Optimus Prime are two rares. Thankfully, this pack wasn't bent at all, so the card was undamaged. And we got a second Top Shot, who we just saw. It goes over there. So we're still due at least one more rare, is my understanding. And potentially a super rare, if we get super lucky, but I doubt we'd do that after the last box had King Starscream in it. Urban Camo Repurpose, I don't know if we saw that one yet. Force Field seems pretty common. Fuel Gauge, Cash, I mean, squish them like bugs. Who is Ultra Magnus stepping on? There must be some of the Battle Masters. And then the rare for this one is Backup Bag. Not sure who that is in that picture. I presume somewhere in here is a General Megatron. No idea what rarity, but I would quite like that to go with General Optimus. Just to have both sides representing. It's an Autobot though, it's Hound again. Cybertronian Truck Hound, which is, what, 9 stars? And he is a common, which I'm fine with. And we got, oh, we got Laserbeak to go with Ravage earlier. So this will probably be the same rarity, which is common, yeah. Nice. If you wanted to run Soundwave, I presume there must be a Soundwave in this wave then to go with them because they're his cassettes. And then we have ourselves Pep Talk, Basic Combat Protocol. Not sure if we've seen that one yet. Battlefield Report we have. EMP Wave we have. Sturdy Armor, not sure we have. And the rare is, oh, speaking of Ravage, is a secret action called Infiltrate. I'd say we're about halfway through the box at this point, maybe just over. Not 100% sure, I don't really count as I do these for the most part. Just enjoy the process. I didn't see any colour there, so I have no idea what this is. Okay, now it's an Autobot. It's a second RC. Our last one was the damaged one, right? Oh, we've got someone who turns into something with a long name. Let me just double check. The RC was the one with the notable crease, right? Yeah, that's bad. Yeah, right there. Okay, you go in the crease pile. I'm sorry, RC. You've been replaced by better RC that is not creased. Dual charge electrostatic photon cannon. Oh, I never leave home without it. It's an uncommon, and that's what he looks. Oh, I recognize his bot form. Yeah, so that's another target master then. It must be, right? Because he turns into a gun. It looks like it's being held by Optimus's hand. That's probably out of focus. That is Optimus's hand. There we go. So, I guess he is an Autobot. Yeah, I recognize his bot form. Anyway, he is uncommon. Of course he is, because he turns into a weapon. That seems to be the trend. And then, I like how the light is catching Optimus's eyes and then the lights on the front of him. At least it is for me from this angle. I don't know if it's picking up on camera. So then we have E Defensive Formation, which is so defensive the camera can't hope to defeat it. We'll just move on then. Diagnosis, Personal Targeting Drone, Extra Padding, we haven't seen that yet. Sturdy Armor, both defensive cards. LV Gamma Disruptor Launcher, that's Shockwave looking very buff, so I guess that's good for him then. Next on the chopping block. I didn't rip as smoothly, but I have an in. And I saw Autobot colours. A new one, we have Trailbreaker. I remember him from the cartoon. His Jeep, I think, had a gun hand. No, apparently not. Unless it's just a more updated version of him. He's an uncommon, though. Uncommon Autobot that we haven't seen yet. So, well, I've been putting Hound goes in this pile, apologies. And he goes in this pile. And another Red Heat, who is proving to be very common. The little guys, I guess there's not that many to choose from, because they do seem quite numerous in duplicates. I haven't really been separating the duplicates of them, but we've had at least 3 Red Heats now, I think. At least. So, we've got ourselves a Dismantle. Force Field again. Calculated Strike. Full loadout, haven't seen that yet. Some Power Armor going on in Optimus. Device Virus, haven't seen that yet either, and the rare. Emergency Defense Field. Neat. I just checked there and we have three duplicates, which you can sort of see up here. One top shot and two private red heats for the little guys in terms of duplicates there. Oh, we have an Autobot. It is private sideswipe. So we've got another duplicate. I can't remember if his was a damaged card, so I'll have to check after. But rather than just do it now, but he's an uncommon. And we got, oh, speaking of duplicates, there's Ravage again. A common, so that's to be expected, but I'll put him up there then, since he is a duplicate. And I'll make sure to keep the nicest looking old versions. The packs haven't seemed as damaged now. It seemed to only be like the first half of both sides. Basic combat protocol, reactive armor, brainstorm, full loadout again, point defense system, and two-pronged attack, Starscream and Megatron working together. First time seeing this. Both side swipes were of equal quality, so I've put one on the duplicate pile now, just to keep track. Get this open smooth. I think I saw Autobot colours. I did. We got a second Sergeant Chromia. Oops. So we've already seen her. I'll put that to one side and pick which one looks nicer. Oh, we got a new little guy though. We got Detour. A Decepticon one as well. We've mostly been getting Autobots. I don't remember him, but he is a common. It's desperately trying to focus on something behind for some reason. It really wants you to re-see the private side sweep. But swipe, I mean, not sweep. Okay, he turns into a little slightly weird looking car, but he is a common as well, because of course he is, because he is a figure with a car form, rather, not a gun or a scythe. And then down there, our battle cards for this one are, starting with reactive armor, basic combat protocol, personnel targeting drone, sturdy armor, a second extra padding. They seem to buff off of each other, so I think you want a lot. And then a second unconventional flying object with Alpha Trion. We're into the last third now. Will I get the Ultra Magnus as I kick the camera? Oh, that was a punch actually. But either way, well, we got a second Hound, that's what we got for sure. Again, I can't remember if he was the damaged one or not. I don't think he was, but either way, second Hound, I'll look into that in a second. Oh, a new little guy. I don't think we've had a sergeant or private flak. Turns into a missile launcher guy that has stealth. And he is, of course, a common, because he doesn't turn into a weapon. I feel like we would have seen a rare little guy by now if they came in that variety. So we have a secret action battlefield report. We've got a pep talk. That's an old card. First one we've seen in this wave, I think, though maybe second. Anticipation engine, that's a few of them we've seen. Metal detector, and the rare is a second quartermaster. I feel like we've had more duplicate characters in this booster box than any of the others we did. I don't know if that's just bad luck or if that's just something that we changed with the general chances as this went on. We've got one of the Insecticons. We have Sergeant Scrapnel, who is a common. Great picture though. Love that. Very nice. Insecticon leader, who is melee focused, and is just a common, but we haven't seen him. And we got a new little guy too, Private Stakeout, who is a car, so he'll be a common. Yep, of course. I think I had this toy as well. I remember having the police car little guy, but I don't remember him looking like that in bot form. But this is many, many, many years ago we're talking about, so won't fully remember. Okay, we've got another urban camel. The camera always struggles to see them, which is the point. Force field, smoke cloak, bolster, point defense system, and the rare, erratic energy grenade. First one of these we've seen with a single black pip and nothing else. Next on the chopping block, I choose this pack, and it opened okay, once I got into the little seam there. And we have inside Major Soundwave. Okay, we got Soundwave, nice. Each of your spy patrols. Isn't that the children's cartoon about dogs? Oh, that's a cool picture of Soundwave though. That's great. He isn't uncommon, but we have Laserbeak, we have Ravage, so presumably he works well with them. Oh, I bet they count as spy patrols. I'm not used to him being a jet. I'm used to him being a cassette player and a Jeep. But either way, uncommon. You know, it feels like it's been a bit since I've put something on the uncommon pile. And we got Roadhugger, which I believe is our second, and that is of course a common. I'll double check that in between takes. And our battle cards are as follows. Medic! I can only ever hear the heavy from Team Fortress shouting medic when that's all that's written. Smoke thrower, dismantling claw, don't think we've seen that yet. Battlefield scan, I'm pretty sure that's new as well. Squish them like bugs, that's the second one of them. And then dampening field is the rare, I think that's the first one of these we've seen. Not only was Roadhugger a duplicate stakeout, was also a duplicate. Forgot they'd already looked at him, I just looked at him closer. Alright, here we go, it is Trigger Happy. I think I remember him from the Headmasters era. Let me see him in bot form. Maybe. Vaguely. He isn't uncommon, so it's going on top of the pile with Soundwave right there, very nice. And we got a second Flak, common, perfectly fine, no damage, and then just battle cards. I would say we have 6 packs left, maybe 7. We're still due one more rare, at least. It always is the Urban Camel, huh? It's a living joke, there we go. Pep Talk, personal targeting drone. Electron Breacher, Rock Toss, oh, and 2 in a row, Dampening Field. Alright, I double checked, there's exactly 7 packs left after this one. So, if you included this one, 8. But this one is already dead, don't mourn for him. Let's see what is inside. You'd think the advertisements would be facing outwards. We got our second Trailblazer, so it is a repeat. He was uncommon, I think. Yep, so it's our uncommon duplicate. The other one I remember was perfectly fine and looked good, so he can go over there. And we got our second Nightstick, or potentially third, but either way, definitely a repeat, because he's the one I remember from the cartoon. Only in bot form. And the battle cards. Another one that it struggles with, I guess, just because of all the text, there we go. Defensive Formation, Repurpose, Battlefield Report, Steady Shot, Reflex Circuits. Oh yeah, we've seen that, Megatron doing the zooms. And Heat of Battle, that's new. Also pretty fun. Okay, so that is our new rare, haven't seen any of them yet. Alright, running out of time, running out of packs. Fingers crossed. Here we go. That's going to fall off the table, I'll put it over there. Major Prowl, okay, it is a new one. We don't have a Major Prowl yet, so a new version of Prowl. Oh, and a new little guy too. It's a common, so I'm surprised we haven't seen him yet, with how many duplicates we've been getting. That's classic Prowl right there, that's how he looks in my mind. So that goes on the common pile right there. And then we have Raider Stormcloud, so he'll be common as well. Don't remember him. The text is a little small on these smaller cards, obviously. We probably wanted to have that a bit more tight. But either way, it's another one for scrapping green cards. Actually, is it the same guy and I've just forgotten? It could just have the same role. Brainstorm, Laser Launcher, Repurpose, Battlefield Scan, full loadout and rare is our second, I believe, heroic team up. And now we have whatever this is. One that doesn't open that well. Is it a sign? Probably not. Oh, it really is hard to rip open now, because of the part that ripped off is the part I usually pull the seam with. I'm going to have to do it upside down. It's the Australian pack. Oh, that actually opens super easy from this side. Very well, we'll do it upside down and then remember to turn it back up this way. And we have ourselves another run amok. Well, he's certainly common. Yeah, we're getting a load more duplicates with this wave than previous, and there's apparently 148 characters in this wave, so it is a little, I don't know, suspicious probably isn't the right word, because what advantage do they have really if they did make stuff rare, because it would be the second hand market that makes a profit off of that, not them. Well, unless you buy packs to try and get the rare things that are worth money, I suppose. Hiding Spot, I think that's new. Bolster, and then the rare is a second Laser Cutlass. It's the same person, isn't it? Who I'm just going to call Lady Cup. The number of duplicates we're getting will absolutely be forgiven if I get the Super Rare Master. I don't even know if he's any use in the game itself. Oh, we got Alpha Trion. I've never seen him in his vehicle form. He's basically like a flying battleship. I don't think he ever transformed in the show, the original cartoon. Oh, he's our third rare, so that'll be it, unless we have a super rare, for the most part, I think. Unless this, again, it could be different now. Very, very cool picture of him, though. He's never looked so buff and tough. Yeah, they made him look neat. And as I say, I've never seen his vehicle form. Almost like a sky yacht. He's classed as a spaceship, that makes sense. And we got another Mudslinger, but that is our third rare. Two Autobots, one Decepticon. Obviously a repeat there. And our battle cards are down here. We've got, what, three packs left? Four packs left? I think that is our quota of rares met. Unless we get a very strangely laid out box. But there is still a chance of a super rare because they don't take a rare slot. At least didn't seem to for wave two. Personal targeting drone, dismantling claw, frag toss, device virus, covert armor. Oh, and our first secret action, or version of this anyway, take cover. Even if there isn't any rares or super rares left in any of these packs, I'm sure there's still characters we haven't seen. So let's see what we get. Well, we got what we started with, which is Ion Storm. And how many characters? Yeah, 148. Does that say, or does that just say 48? I think it just says 48. And we got a second Binary Edgewing Scythe, which I presume you're only allowed one of these each as well. So that's two repeats there, which is not great. Number of repeats in general in this particular wave is not great. But again, it's hard to tell for sure if the whole thing was like this based on one box. Dismantling Claw, Diagnosis, Medic, Fuel Cache, Extra Padding, that's our third or fourth. And we got, just to taunt me, our second Ultra Magnus Armor. This is it, the last three packs. Let's see what's inside. I'm going to open them all together. Just toss that to one side. Well, with our third Sideswipe, I believe, uncommon. Yeah, right. We have ourselves our third Laserbeak, I believe. So not so great there, but still, we have ourselves a chance at one of the rare battle cards, if nothing else. Urban Camo, we all know it's not going to focus on this. Urban Camo, Combat Dagger, our second one of them, I think. Reactive Armor, Hiding Spot. Compact Shield, I don't think we've seen that yet. An Autobot upgrade. Ooh, RR Disruptor Blade. RC's going to go shiv somebody. Jeez, she's very mean. Okay, I'll sort those off camera because we're just going to do the final three in one clip. I'll sort them in my own time. I did see Autobot colours. Who is it? Alright, I can't remember if we've had Ratchet or not. Did we have Ratchet? I don't recognise the R. He's an uncommon. I don't think we have. Uncommon, I'm trying to see who he's... I think it's one of the headmasters he's treating, isn't it? The one that turns into a helicopter. Okay, so he is an uncommon. That's neat. Another stakeout, so that's definitely a duplicate. And then after this, one last chance. I think I mentioned at the top of the video, like Siege 1 booster boxes and packs seem to be the hardest to get outside of the very final wave that I'll talk more about later. Reactive Armor, Anticipation Engine, Sturdy Armor, and our second, I think, Energy Pack, which is not too bad. I almost turned the camera off there because I forgot. Nope, we're doing all three at once. It all comes down to this. Will there be a Wonka golden ticket inside? We may never know. Let's try opening it from this side. There we go. It actually opens up really easy from down there. And we got ourselves a Decepticon, so no Ultra Magnus for me. And it's another runabout. Oof, 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 oof. And another Mudslinger as well. Quadruple oof. And our final battle cards are difficult to open. There we go. So we got ourselves Frag Toss, Smoke Cloak. Hopefully in focus in a second. Smoke Cloak, Dismantle, second Compact Shield, Battlefield Scan, and a second Callous Leadership. And that is all she wrote. So a bit of a disappointing one compared to the previous booster boxes. Not just because I didn't get the super rare I was looking for, obviously, that has a ridiculously low occurrence rate. Super rares in general, 1 in 50 packs, there's 30 in here, and I'm sure there was more than just one super rare in this wave. Couldn't tell you what they are, but I'm sure there was at least three. So, astronomically low chance to get the character I wanted, but seeing the cards come out the packs damaged because they've clearly been bent in production, That's very disappointing. And just the sheer number of duplicates compared to the previous boxes we've unboxed, the Wave 1 and Wave 2. Ridiculous number of duplicates. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 out of 30 duplicate characters. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, almost half duplicates of the little guys. Although granted, I presume there's not that many of those. But yeah, in terms of number of duplicates, you can let me know if you opened up any of these back in the day. Was it all like this? Was it quite as bad as this one seemed to be for duplicates? Because if so, I could even see that putting off people who were behind the game, let alone anyone trying to get in at this wave. But in terms of our rares, still did fine in that regard. Alpha Tryon, General Optimus Prime, and yet another rare version of Starscream in his Cybertronian form. So I do feel like I want to finish the set. I want to find a Siege 2 booster box and do that, just to finish the main game's lifespan. There was a wave after Siege 2 called Masters, I think, which was more focused on headmasters. That was the gimmick. You could put heads on bot bodies to give them stats. As far as I can tell, that's basically it. Like, if it ever hit the UK, it didn't land in many places from the brief amount of research I've done. It was mostly sent as like free samples to influencers and content creators, but they probably knew at that point the writing was on the wall that they weren't going to do very much with it, so I presume not much was produced. And as a result, I don't think there would be any chance of me ever tracking down a booster box of that. But Siege 2, I could probably manage Siege 2 just to finish this weird little reverse journey through the lifespan, the short lifespan of this game. I thought it lasted 4 years. It just lasted 2, as far as I can tell. Or maybe just slightly into the third year, but either way, yeah, it did not last as long as I thought. And it does feel like a shame. But if they started increasing the number of duplicates while also boasting about increasing the number of rares, I could definitely see that as annoying people, if that is something that, who knows, maybe you'll tell me in the comments. Anyway, yeah, I think we're going to do one more of these. I want to track down a Siege 2 booster. I want to finish the quadrilogy, as it were, and just see where the path takes us. Thank you for watching this to the end. If you did, though, I hope you enjoyed this oddity again, and I'll see you just for at least one more time. Until then, ta-ta for now.